Forgive her, it's my daughter Celine. I'm on camera tonight. Usually my son is, but he's at home sick. It seems like a lot of people have been sick this past couple weeks and probably not going to get any better anytime soon. So let's keep the people in our prayers that are going through that. So we got a lot of people from our congregation that aren't here because of illness. And we'll keep that in our minds. Also, I heard there was an accident at the top of the mountain. Don't know much details. I just know that the road is closed. And I heard there was a possible fatality. It's tragic, especially this time of year. I don't know if that's true or not. It's just really important. But a lot of people are traveling, and we need to keep them in our prayers as well. So before we start, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for getting us all here safely tonight to celebrate your son Jesus' birthday, the time that we get together and be thankful for the many gifts you've given us, including him. We appreciate all the things that you've given us, our families, our health, our ability to gather together. Please continue to strengthen us and guide us and look after those that are traveling and those that are away from their families. Please continue to look after the emergency workers, the firemen, the police officers, the ambulance drivers, the hospital personnel as they're taking care of the people that are traveling. Please give us a wonderful evening and bless us with your wisdom and your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Okay, for those of you who haven't been with us, this is what we've been doing the past few years. And we were thinking, why is it so late? Why are we starting so late? Well, it's because so many other churches do their services earlier. We want to give you an opportunity to go to other churches and experience other churches and then come home to us. Even if you're visiting, like you consider this your home, away from home, you're always welcome, and we'd love to have you. To begin tonight's program, we've got the children that will be singing a couple songs for us. In a moment, so stall. You know, we're going to be after midnight now. All right, I'm stalling.
Thank you.
So the kids were practicing this these couple songs for a while now, and they did a first attempt last weekend, and they did wonderful. The recording wasn't the greatest, but it's out on our YouTube page. And I encourage you all, if you get a chance, to go find us on YouTube and like our subscribe to our page. Subscribe to YouTube, like Facebook, right? We've got a Facebook page and a YouTube channel. Please join us and see our past sermons and some other events that we do. This is a wonderful group of people. Every Tuesday, we feed the homeless and the needy out in Martinsburg. Up until, or for the past 2 years, we've been on the square in downtown Martinsburg. Starting, not this week, but the following week, we're going to be at a church right next to the library. Continuing that because the city of Martinsburg has decided to charge anybody that is trying to help people $500 a night to use the square, and that's horrendous. And I encourage you all to register to vote if you're in the Martinsburg area and vote everybody out. And not supposed to be political here in the church, but we have to. We have to stand up for Christian beliefs. And if they don't like people helping people, then they're not Christian. And if we continue to give way and just roll over and let that happen, the next thing we know is coming is they'll start closing down churches again. We can't have that. So let's put that aside and enjoy this festive occasion. I know that we're all excited. Let's see excited faces right now. Everybody. We've got coffee back there. It's pretty strong. Just saying.
Mm-hmm.
You ready? All right, so let's get the children up here.
Gordon, you coming?
don't know what you have for those lights.
I got it right here.
No setting down is.
If you want to bring it behind here, the words will be on the screen here.
Okay, what's the other one, see the words? Y'all want the papers? I don't know what papers are, so read that.
Gladly.
Recently, FM 91.5. Whenever we're here, we're doing something, it's being broadcast. So if you aren't feeling the greatest, not sure if you want to come in or not, within a 2 mile radius ish, you can hear us on 91.5. So it's kind of exciting and terrifying at the same time, right? So for the rest of the program, we're going to invite you to sing along with us. Classic Christmas carols, and then we have some Bible readings by the members of our congregation. We're voluntold to do it, so I have a lot of fun with that. So it's, if you want to stand and sing, that's great. If you don't, that's okay too.
Well, good evening, everyone, and Merry Christmas to you in advance.
You need them?
No, I think I see it.
Okay.
She can use mine.
Do you want to use her glasses?
No, I think I can see.
Anyway, I'm going to read Luke 1. Verses 5 and 6, the birth of John the Baptist foretold. In the time of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah, who belonged to the priestly division of Abijah. His wife Elizabeth was also a descendant of Aaron. Both of them were righteous in the sight of God, observing all the Lord's commands and decrees blamelessly.
Okay, I'm going to read Luke 1, 26 and 27. Elizabeth became pregnant with John the Baptist. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary.
Baby boy, your name of God.
That's a note, not a whole song.
We will be reading Luke 1, 28 through 38. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid. Mary, you have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end."
"How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I'm a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who is said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month, for no word from God will ever fail."
"I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her.
Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to the public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save you, his people, from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus.
Issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Merry Christmas, everybody.
Heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. On the eighth day, when it was time to circumcise the child, he was named Jesus, the name the angel had given him before he was conceived.
Thank you. Yeah.
It's really me this time. I just like to keep y'all guessing. I'll be reading from Matthew 2:1-12. The Magi visit the Messiah. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw the star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was very disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judea, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Through him all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness was not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John, and he came to witness and testify concerning the light, so that through him all might believe.
He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and through the world was made through him. The world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwellings among us. We have seen his glory, the glory, the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. John testified concerning him. He cried out, saying, "This is the one I spoke about when I said, 'He who comes after me has surpassed me because he was before me.' Out of his fullness we have all received grace in place of grace already given. For the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but the one and only Son, who himself God and is in the closest relationship with the Father, has made him known."
Think about the people you know. Once you
That's spread out to the next person.
Once you may be ill, once you may be traveling, once you may be struggling, the ones who may be not quite saved. Think about them.
They
done
gave her a tricky
hand.
Some of the weeks might not be very big.
These candles haven't been tested since last year, so.
I don't do things here one, bro.
I think I did too.
Larry and I joke around
about this. So we
check, we want to check the fire extinguisher.
It's better to put it out than blow fire.
I tried it and it wouldn't.
So again, when you light the candles, think about people that you know and love that are traveling, that are away from their loved ones, that are sick, that are injured, that are struggling. Keep them in your hearts and your minds. We had a rough start, but we're still beating these guys.
Take your paper and put it out like that, so it won't burn your hands.
Oh yeah.
We're not supposed to be there.
With the dawn of
This time we get to spend together in fellowship and praise and worship in you. Thank you for the words that you have written down and kept for us to guide us and strengthen us. Help us come closer to you. We love you, Lord, and we want to honor you every day. Thank you for all of this church family and these friends for coming out and joining us. Please look after the ones that aren't here. Strengthen the ones that are sick and injured. Be with the ones that are in travels. And comfort the ones that are lost. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Focus on the gifts and the food and the family.
And the cake.
And the cake. The food, the family. But we always got to have this in our minds. This is about the celebration of the gift that God gave us, Jesus Christ, his birth. And what better way to remind us of that is to sing happy birthday to him and have some cake.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Jesus, happy birthday.